What's happening, guys? Keith here with your October 20th edition of the Impact Report. So if you haven't checked out my review of this past week's episode of Impact, you can do so by clicking the link at the top of the screen. And speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 189,000 viewers, which is 3.3% up from last week's 183,000 viewers, and ranked 148 on cable's top 150. This was the last time it will be airing at the 8 p.m. primetime slot before it moves to the 10 p.m. slot next week. So according to ProWrestling.net, Impact Wrestling is receiving $1 million per year in their current deal with Pop TV. This breaks down to about $20,000 an episode. While they're still getting paid, it really isn't that much considering the show runs 50 weeks a year with new content, plus the 2 weeks of recap shows. Definitely interesting news, as most of us were under the impression that their deal with Pop TV was a barter deal. It seems like they make money on deals outside of the U.S., like their India deal, which I think they make a good portion of money from. But it seems like now they're going to be making more money in the digital departments, YouTube, Twitch, etc. So heading over to Impact's YouTube page, look at the top three viewed clips from this past week's episode of Impact. Number three, Brian Cage versus Rich Swann for the X Division Championship. This had 47,000 views. Number two, Phoenix issues a world title challenge to Johnny Impact. This had 89,000 views. And number one, a changed Allie snaps versus Alicia. This had 93,000 views. So about 36 hours removed from Thursday's episode of Impact. Taking a look at all the clips they posted that were highlights of the show, did around 500,000 views. So that's pretty significant. So we're 6 days removed from Bound for Glory, and they also had clips posted on their YouTube page highlighting the show, and those clips totaled over 1.1 million views. So that is good stuff right there for Impact's YouTube page. So it seems like post Bound for Glory, there was a lot of conflicting reports coming out, mainly with the whole Austin Aries situation. A lot of reports were saying it was a work, while others were saying it was a shoot, and you had sites kind of battling back and forth. Tessa, Brian Cage, and Sami Callihan were all guests on the Busted Open radio show this week, where they had all spoke their thoughts on the whole situation. Petey Williams even spoke about it on his podcast, but he was saying that Austin Aries' contract is indeed up. Many still have questioned how much truth there is to the Aries situation. It is very complicated and controversial exit. I mean, while it's not the most positive thing, there was definitely some buzz coming out of Bound for Glory. But of course, there was some negative articles, and I guess negative in my perception of it, is that there was an article stating that Impact Wrestling was looking into re-signing Alberto El Patron. However, that was later shot down, thankfully, but it seems like there's just a lot of bad news out there. And I mean, I guess that's just kind of the age we live in, where it's just people are posting stuff to get hits and views and things like that. But we do have some positive news. PWInsider.com is reporting that Impact Wrestling and Sami Callihan have come to terms on a new contract. As of this writing, the length of the contract has not been confirmed. We all know Sami made his debut at Bound for Glory last year, and he has definitely been a bright spot over this past year. It was also hyped this past week on Impact about the debut of Jordynne Grace. PW Insider reports that the word backstage was that Grace has signed a 2-year deal. This is excellent news, as Grace will make a fantastic addition to the Knockouts roster. If you guys had seen the All-In pre-show, you saw her epic encounter with Brian Cage. 2018 has definitely been a great year for the Knockouts division, but 2019 looks even better. I know it's going to kind of be a short broadcast today. I don't really have much going on. But last, I have an article from thedailyddt.com. It's saying Impact Wrestling needs to build a Moose versus Killer Cross feud. So I'm going to read a little bit from the article, and then I'll leave a link down in the comments section for you guys to check it out. So it says, Impact Wrestling made what we could kindly describe as an interesting choice when they had Killer Cross, who they'd been promoting for months as a vindictively sadist heel, playing a second fiddle of sorts to then-Impact World Champion Austin Aries. They then made an even more interesting choice when they had Moose, who had a very deep running and emotional feud with Aries going into Slammiversary, betray his best friend Eddie Edwards and align himself with Aries and Cross seemingly out of nowhere. However, now, it seems that Aries is done with Impact Wrestling for the time being, and Cross and Moose are left to hold down the fort for the leaderless Aries crew by themselves. So it was a really good article. If you read it through, I mean, they definitely should go the route with the slow burn, and we'll eventually get the said Cross versus Moose match. Next week's Impact, we have a world title match with Johnny Impact defending against Phoenix. I think they also mentioned it was going to be Cross and Moose versus KM and Fala Ba. So that looks to be a good episode. I don't know what my plan is for next week. I may just do a Saturday show of news and a review of Impact. I have a lot of stuff going on next weekend, so that's probably the route I'm going to go. If anything changes, I will let you guys know. But thanks for checking out my video. And until next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.